Mantra-tas-tantra-tas-chidram Desha-kala-ravastuta Sarvam-karoti-nishchidram Anu-sankirtanam-tapa Mantra-ta In pronouncing the Vedic mantras in Brahman. Tantrata, in insufficient knowledge, the following regulative principles. Chidram, discrepancy. Desha, in the matter of the country. Kala, and time, arha, and recipient, bastata, and paraphernalia, sarvam, all these, karoti, makes, vishchidram, without discrepancy, anusankirtanam, constantly chanting the holy name, Tava, of your Guruji. There may be discrepancies in pronouncing the mantras and observing the regulative principles. And moreover, there may be discrepancies in regard to time, place, person, and paraphernalia. But when your Lordship's holy name is chanted, everything becomes faultless. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has recommended Padrinama Padrinama Padrinam Eva Kevalam Palo nasteva, 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 gathya pandita. In this age of quarrel and hypocrisy, the only means of deliverance is chanting the holy name of the Lord. There is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. Vihanaradiya Puran. In this age of Kali, it is extremely difficult to perform Vedic ritualistic ceremonies or sacrifices perfectly. Hardly anyone can chant the Vedic mantras with perfect pronunciation or accumulate the paraphernalia for Vedic performances. Therefore, the sacrifice recommended in this age is sankirtan. Constant chanting of the holy name of the Lord. Yajyai sankirtana prayar yajanti hi sumedasa. Instead of wasting time performing Vedic sacrifices, those who are intelligent, those who possess good brain substance, should take to the chanting of the Lord's holy name and thus perform sacrifice perfectly. I have seen that many religious leaders are addicted to performing yajnas and spending hundreds and thousands of rupees for imperfect sacrificial performances. This is a lesson for those who unnecessarily execute such imperfect sacrifices. We should take the advice of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Yajyai sankirtana prayaya janti hi sumedasaha. Although Sukracharya was a strict Brahmin, addicted to ritualistic activities, he also admitted, Nishchidram anusankirtanam tava. My Lord, constant chanting of the holy name of your Lordship makes everything perfect. In Kali Yuga, the Vedic ritualistic ceremonies cannot be performed as perfectly as before. Therefore, Srila Jiva Goswami has recommended that although one should take care to follow all the principles in every kind of spiritual activity, especially in the worship of the deity, there is still a chance of discrepancies. And one should compensate this, one should compensate for this by chanting the holy name of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In our Krishna consciousness movement, we therefore give special stress to the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra in all activities.
Om Ajnanam Tibhidambasya Jnanam Jana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadamayam Tadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yukapadamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamsa Shri Rupam Sakrachatam Sarapana Ramunathambitam Tam Sajivam Sakvetam Sakadutam Parichana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Patam Sarapana Ramunathambitam Shri Vishapambitamscha Me Krishna Karuna Sindhu Nila Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopita Panta Radha Panta Namoskite Tatya Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranami Hari Priye Vansha Kalpataru Vrascha Kriva Sindhu Vyayevacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasati Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna Krishna
honor and my fortune to have this opportunity to try to serve you by speaking something on behalf of Srila Prabhupada and our Guru Parampara. I was asked to speak about the chanting of Krishna's holy names. So many people have come from all over the world for our kirtan mela. It is really something beautiful to see. Bhaktivinoda Thakur had this dream. The people from all races and all castes and all walks of life would gather together in Sri Mayapur Dham as brothers and sisters in the family of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who raise their arms and loudly cry out with one heart and one voice the holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna, 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 Hare.
Nityananda Prabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also expressed their will for that very purpose. Bhaktivinoda Thakur his final instructions to his son, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada, very much emphasized the glorification of Sri Mayapur Dham. Thakur Bhakti Vinod himself made his home in Gotrandhi. And it was his great desire to discover the birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because he saw that people who were materially oriented had created an apparent birthplace for economic purposes. And obviously finding the birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was part of his master plan to bring the world to come here, to glorify. And through research of scriptures, ancient maps, discussion with great saints and sages, he discovered the actual place. But for confirmation, he wanted the blessings of the greatest Vaishnavacharya of the time, Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, who at that time was very old. In fact, his servant would carry him in a basket because he couldn't walk. And when they brought him to this place, which mystically was filled with tulsi, when they put the basket down, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, who hadn't walked for years, he leaped high in the sky, crying out, Jai Sachinanda, Jai Sachinanda. This is the birthplace of Sri Chaitanya. And he danced. Today is Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj's disciple. So much of what we have received has come through his divine grace. And Srila Prabhupada, on the order of his Guru Maharaj, brought this message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chintya Veda Veda Tapa, that we are all servants of the Absolute Supreme Personality of God, eternal. And that ecstatic love of Krishna is within the heart of every living being. By chanting Krishna's holy names, especially this Mahamantra, his love is awakened. Srila Prabhupada came to the West with this message before boarding the Jagaduta. He stopped in Shantipur and spoke to a pujari and said, my Guru Maharaj has given me an order that is impossible. And in Tamsin Square Park under an elm tree, not a kadamba tree, or a tamal tree, or a banyan tree, an elm tree. But he made that elm tree a holy place. Thousands of people come every year to that elm tree in this park. It's filled with people who are mostly homeless. Because great personalities, their compassion makes a place. We didn't have mridanga. Someone gave him an old little bongo drum. That bongo drum is still there. You can look at it. And he played it, and he chanted. Gradually a little temple, and a storefront, in a very downtrodden place, the Lower East Side was established. and Pandava Maharaj, Javati Devi. They were inspired to go to San Francisco. They established a little storefront there. Because in those days, that was the standard. It's amazing how standards are whatever somebody before you did. Yes? They started a storefront in 26 Second Avenue. Not that that's the extent of what Prabhupada wanted. But then, you know, wherever we go, we should start a storefront. This is the Hare Krishna moment. And the first several temples were storefronts. This is what Prabhupada wanted. So they had a storefront in H.H.Radhanathi Swami. They chanted on the streets. Actually, the first time I think it was Gaur Purnima, and the devotees were waiting at the storefront. Srila Prabhupada was in an apartment a few blocks away, and the devotees decided to chant together along the street to Prabhupada's apartment and be under his window. He was so happy. This is what we should be doing. Go out into the street and chant. After some time, His Holiness Jamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj, along with His Holiness Vishwajana Swami Maharaj, came and gave their hearts and souls, their lives to Shiva. Today is Jamal Krishna Goswami's disappearance days. And he would be empowered by Srila Prabhupada to take those to another level. He actually organized really powerful first-class advertisements. Srila Prabhupada was so pleased with him. He would go from temple to temple, organizing their street non-centered. And then he organized a little later the distribution of back-to-back magazines and brought it from just a few to thousands and tens of thousands. You know, when they described the starter to distribute books, he's organized book distribution, turned it to another level. He brought all of this land in my apartment. But so many people failed to try to get anything because there was so much opposition. So he turned to Jamal Krishna Goswami. Give me this land. Jamal Krishna Goswami tells in Calcutta, the same temple, the same room, and Albert Baird is still there. Srila Prabhupada gave him money and taught him how to take like a piece of cloth and wrap it around the waist and put all the money there. There were no checks. Because in those days, week. There was all sorts of ways you had to do things. And he came here and somehow or other he convinced the people to sell the land. And all those hundreds and hundreds of rupees, every one, the serial number had to be copied. So it took a long time. And when he finally came back to Calcutta with the deed, it was late at night. Srila Prabhupada did not go to sleep. He was so concerned. He was just sitting, waiting. But the light was on. And Srila Swami Maharaj came in and said, Prabhupada, you have the land. Mayapur town, here is the deed. Srila Prabhupada, with tears in his eyes, embraced it. Thank you. And later on, when our movement was spreading in so many ways, inconceivable, he told Jamal Krishna Goswami, go to China and preach. I don't know if anyone ever thought of that. But he did. And now, in a festival, hundreds of people from China are here today with their arms raised, chanting to him. In fact, in his last visit to Mayapur in his life, especially after GBC meetings, people are really exhausted. Maybe not all of you, but GBCs. Nrsimha Swami decided to start a kirtan in his room upstairs. And he just wanted devotees to come together and chant. A few people began, just a few people, because he wanted it. Everybody was very inclined. And the kirtans were so deep and so devotional, so connected. Every day, the amount of people that would come there would multiply and multiply. And soon the temple book, his quarters completely filled with people in the windows and people in the hallways for hours chanting. This went on for about a week or so. And then it was proposed to him, there's so many people, let's take it to the temple every night. They took it to the temple and the temple was full. And this is kind of how this kirtan mantra began. That is all now wrapped. In regard to the holy names, with your permission, I'd like to tell a little story. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu returned from Gaya, he was transformed. Before he went, he was Nimai Pandit, the greatest scholar in creation. And he would love to debate on all sorts of grammatical rules and philosophical terminologies. And devotees, anything that's disconnected from love and service to Krishna is just not important. But Nimai, he would approach the devotees and challenge them with all sorts of grammatical debates. They would chant together, perform their japa, do their puja with the prayer, please make Nimai a devotee. Because we love him, we can't give up his association, but at the same time, it's so difficult to associate with him. And if he becomes a devotee, the whole world will chant your holy names. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Gaya to teach a very sacred principle. When bhakti comes, when we become the servant of the servant of the Vaishnava and accept a spiritual master. It was in Gaya that he approached Sri Padishwara Puri and begged him for initiation. It was in Gaya that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifested his Radha Bhava, the love of Sri Radha. That was his very heart. And when he came back to Navadvipa, the devotees were celebrating. We had never seen a devotee like Nimai. And soon after, he established kirtan with all of these devotees in the house of Srinivas. But only the most confidential associates who had pure ecstatic love for Krishna were given entrance into those kirtans. Because they were so deep, so ecstatic, incomprehensible to common people. They could just completely express the ecstasies of their love to each other. When these kirtans were going on all night long, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita tells that they would chant during the day at Srinivasa's. And one day Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, time is so precious. Why do we waste our nights sleeping? We should have kirtan all night long. And Lord Chaitanya said, They said, yes, we will do.
And that's where these online kirtans began. The envious people, the arrogant people, because Navadvipa was filled with great, great scholars. They would criticize, blaspheme Srivas, Lord Chaitanya, and all those devotees. Because they were loudly chanting Krishna's names, which was against their principles, and because they were not allowed in. They would spread so many rumors. These Vaishnavas, they have nothing to do with the Vedic culture. They're simply sentimentalists. They're useless because they're so hungry, they're crying all night in hunger pains. We know what they're doing. They're going out during the day and finding nice young girls and inviting them in, and then they have all sorts of terrible tantric black rites and then violate the chastity of these girls, and they drink liquor, and they're singing. That's what they're doing in there. And they won't let us in because we will expose their hypocrisy. Others were saying, this Luma is crazy. He's going to destroy our whole village. What happens if the Kazi finds out that they're singing out loud? We're all going to suffer. We should take Srivas and all these devotees, we should bind their necks with ropes, put rocks at the other end, and throw them in the Ganges. We should tear down this house and throw it in the Ganges. This is how they were speaking. Luckily, there was no internet in those days. So, the pious people, which was the majority, they loved me. They could see that he was the greatest saint of all saints. They yearned for his mercy. They heard about his dancing. They were praying and crying that someday they could become fortunate and go into the house of Srivas and see the Lord dance and join his kirtan. But because of these critical people, Nimai is keeping the doors closed. So those nice people of Navadvipa, they would come in the early morning and bring Nimai gifts. One day, a crowd came and they all paid their dandavats to Lord Chaitanya. Then they gave him gifts of love. They were simple gifts. Some gave him bananas, coconuts, mangoes. Some brought some water from the Ganges. Some brought some ghee or some dahi. And they stood before Lord Chaitanya with humble fold hands. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was moved by them. And then a historical event. Lord Gauranga told them, my brothers, my sisters, hear what I say. I beg you, please always perform devotional service to Krishna. Constantly chant his holy names. Never, ever forget the Lord's holy names. And today I am going to give you the greatest of all mantras, the Maha Mantra. And he told the people to repeat after him, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
He said, chant this mantra, chant japa, according to a prescribed number every day, and come together for kirtan. Whether you're alone, or with your family, your mothers, your fathers, your children, your brothers, your sisters, clap your hands and chant.
If you have instruments, mridangas, karatals, conch shells, play the instruments and chant. There are no hard and fast rules for this chanting of the holy names. Wherever you may be, whoever you're with, keep your tongue always decorated with the holy name of Krishna. And you may also chant this song. Adi Hadai Vibhama Krishna Jada Vayam Samaha Jada Vayam Samaha Jada Vayam Samaha Gopal Govinda Dham Srimadhu Sudhahe
Gopal Govinda Dham Srimadhu Sudhahe.
Now go home. And in all the villages and all the towns, spread this chanting of the holy names. Everyone was blissful. They all went to their homes, ecstatic. And soon, thousands and thousands of people everywhere were chanting Krishna's name. So Lord Chaitanya would go down the streets, and when he would see people chanting, he would take with his own lotus-like hands and put garlands around their necks. He would embrace them. He would put straw between his own teeth and say, I beg you, please always chant Hare Krishna. That gave him so much courage. Everywhere in all directions, people were clapping their hands, playing their instruments, and chanting. And this made the atheistic and arrogant people extremely angry. One day, the Qazi, who was the government official who actually had all powers over the Nadia district, Chand Qazi, he had already, under the order of the king of Bengal, made a law against any public demonstration of the Hindu religion. Now he sees people blissfully right out in the open chanting. He was furious. He was always surrounded by a large army of soldiers. He cried out, catch them, punish them. And the poor people ran away. And some of them were caught, severely beaten. Some were imprisoned, some were exploited of whatever plundered, of whatever property they had. Chand Qazi said, because it's night, I will not be so severe with you, but if you ever do this again, you will be severely punished. From that day on, Chand Qazi had thousands of soldiers throughout the entire day and night looking for anybody who would be chanting and punished. So the people became very afraid and they went to Lord Chaitanya's home. And when he came out of his door, they expressed their sorrow. They couldn't give up the chanting. So they said, we are all going to leave Nadia because it's too difficult to live here. When Lord Chaitanya saw them, he felt great compassion. He entered into the moon of Rudra, which is the form of Shiva at the time of destruction. And with a thunderous voice, he cried out, Nityananda, go to the homes of all the Vaishnavas with this message. Today, I will personally dance through all the streets of Navadvip chanting the holy name. See who does anything to me. Today I will take our chanting right to the doorstep of the Chand Qazi.
Let us see what his king does to me. Today I will bring a great rainstorm of pure devotional service, and I will inundate all of Nadia with ecstatic love for Krishna through the chanting of the holy name. Will stand before the blasphemers. Let us see what they do to me. Go. If you want to see Krishna, he told the townspeople, go now and make torches. Then take lunch and come back to my house and meet me. The word spread everywhere. And soon, tens and thousands, hundreds of thousands of people were making torches, according to their capacity. They were only getting large torches. Some people, they made one torch. A father taught a child. The child taught his brothers and sisters. And they were all making torches. Some more wealthy people were having thousands and thousands of torches made. And then, but according to Vrindavanas Tagore, everyone was so excited about this kirtan. Everywhere in Navadvipa, people were thinking, today, the greatest aspiration of our hearts will be fulfilled. We will see Gauranga Mahaprabhu dance! Lord Chaitanya told them to eat lunch, but they all forgot about lunch. Soon there were hundreds and thousands of people at Lord Chaitanya's doorstep. And he came out, and he smiled upon them, and said, Adoita Prabhu, at the front of the kirtan party, you will dance. And many devotees will be gathered around you chanting and dancing. And behind you will be Thakur Haridas. He will be dancing with a crowd of devotees around him. And behind him, Srivas Thakur will dance. And behind him, Lord Chaitanya looked at Lord Nityananda. And Nityananda Prabhu started to cry. He said, I can only be with you. Please never let me be separate from you. Whatever is your will is my heart and soul. I want to dance with you. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, with Nityananda Prabhu on one side and Gadadhar Pandit on the other, were dancing. As he was giving this instruction, he induced everyone to chant. And the Maha Mantra, it was thunderous. Like hundreds of millions of roaring lions, it filled the entire universe, the divine sound of the holy names. And then the sun set. With Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's indication, at the same time, everyone lit their torches. The darkness of the night was not possible. It was the most light that this universe has ever seen. It says it was like the light of Krishna's effulgence in the form of all these torches that lit up the sky. And they, by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's will, the procession began. This was the first Harinam Sankirtan procession in our history.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so beautiful, everyone, as they were chanting and dancing, were gazing upon him. And by his own mystical power, however many people came, even millions, they could all personally, intimately watch him. His hair was so beautiful, like black silk, and it was cascading around his beautiful golden moon-like face. Our scriptures describe on that day his hair was decorated with malati or jasmine flowers. His eyes were lotus-like, and they reached practically to his ears. His eyebrows were like the bows of the Hamadeh. His nose was like a sesame flower. His lips were like the bimba fruit. His face was like a moon, full moon. As he danced, his arms, which were like beautiful golden pillars, were raised very high. There was a garland of flowers around his neck that extended just below his knees that was swaying to and fro as he danced. His ecstasies were so deep that literally torrents of rivers of tears were pouring from his eyes. Sometimes by his dancing, he would be covered with dust, and then at the next moment, the tears would soak his body like a bath and cleanse all the dust. His limbs trembled. His hair was standing on end. On his beautiful golden complexion, it is described that his body looked like a kadamba flower. His dhoti was folded in three places. As he danced, he intoxicated. He took the kirtan along the banks of the Ganges. He went Madhai Ghat, Varapuna Ghat, Nagariya Ghat. As he was chanting, the villagers of Navadvip and the townspeople, they were so excited. They wanted to bless their homes, so they greeted him. Every doorstep of practically every house had banana tree leaves and mangoes and coconuts and little lamps burning to welcome the Lord, so that he would see the auspiciousness of the offering of their love of their homes. But amazingly, when they heard the chant, saw the Lord and all the devotees in such happiness that they forgot everything and ran out to the kirtan. Mothers forgot that they had children or husbands. Fathers forgot that they had wives and children. Children forgot that they had parents or brothers or sisters. Even babies forgot that they were babies. People forgot they were men or women. They forgot where they lived. They forgot everything. They just ran out ecstatically, everyone, to chant and dance with the Lord. All the houses were empty. At this point, all the dacoits and thieves, they were so happy with the promise. Nobody is home anywhere, and they all forgot to close their doors. So they all went running to the homes of people to rob them. But as they were running, they heard the kirtan and saw the devotees chanting, and the thieves forgot that they were thieves. Everyone together was chanting Krishna's holy names. This is real kirtan, where all our material differences are transcended. The devotees, they were so intoxicated with the holy names. Some of them, while they danced. They didn't even know that they could do it, or how they do it, or why they do it. They would dance up to the top of a tall tree.
and then cry out, Hari Bol!
Hari Bol!
And jump from the top of the tree, land on the ground and dance. Devotees were, all the people, they were embracing each other in ecstasies. Some of them were bowing down to each other's feet. Others were tying their hair to another devotee's feet. While they were dancing. And they all had torches. Some of them had two torches. And at the same time were clapping their hands constantly. Vrindavan Das Thakur asked the question, how was that possible? Two gigantic torches, one in each hand, and yet you're dancing and clapping your hands. Because by Lord Chaitanya's mercy, every single devotee in that kirtan became an eternal resident of Vaikuntha and assumed four arms. So they can hold torches and clap at everything. But nobody there knew they had four arms. And they were so engrossed in the chanting of the holy games that no one could see that anyone else had four arms. The demigods. According to Chaitanya Bhagavat, all the demigods, they had never seen anything like this. In history of Brahma's creation, there was never so much bliss in the universe. So the demigods came to see it. They were showering flowers, but nobody even noticed that there were flowers. Nobody cared. They were just looking at Lord Chaitanya and dancing and chanting. The demigods wanted to join, so they all assumed human forms and were dancing and chanting among the devotees. There was no high or low. There was no, you're a farmer and I'm the head of King of Heaven. Everyone was just a Vaishnava chanting and dancing together. Some would climb on other people's shoulders to chant and dance. Meanwhile, the people who were against the devotees, this made them even more angry. They said, just see the audacity and arrogance of this Nimai leading all these people chanting and singing in the streets. We will tell the Kazi. And when the Kazi comes with his armies, they will all run away like cowards, or they will be beaten. So they actually went to Kazi's house and complained that this Nimai Pandit is ruining their whole Hindu religion. And he's breaking the Kazi's laws and must be punished. The Kazi sent soldiers to go and see what was happening. The soldiers came thinking, we are representing the law. They came to the kirtan with this idea of stopping it. But when they saw the enthusiasm, by this time, millions of people. And they saw all the millions of torches. And they saw Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Some of them ran away. And they went to the Kazi. And some of them said, Hari Hari. I went, Hari Hari. And I saw these people, Hari Hari. And this Nimai, we've never seen anything Hari Hari like him. There's rivers of tears flowing from his eyes, and he's so, Hari Hari, so beautiful. And there's millions of people, and they'll do anything he's saying, Hari Hari, and he has so many torches, Hari Hari, and we can't stop saying Hari Hari. Others said, I went, and I was about to tell them they have to stop. But as soon as I raised my hands to speak, my beard caught on fire, burned my face.
And others, you know, they were dressed like kind of military people. They were wearing these turbans. They took off their turbans, they hid their beards, and they chanted with the devotees so they couldn't hear them. Chandrakasi heard this, and he said, it must be a marriage ceremony. I will stop it and punish it personally. And then with his armies, he was about to go out and stop it. But at that point, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in the ecstasy of Radha's love, Shushan Sundar, was chanting and dancing. He brought the whole kirtan party right to Chandrakasi's house. And when Chandrakasi heard the thunderous roar of this kirtan, do you know what he did? He and all of his soldiers scattered in all directions and ran away. I'm out of time, but I'll very briefly speak. It's a beautiful story in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita where Nimai, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he comes to the doorstep of Chandrakasi. And meanwhile, there's people all around him, and some of them are breaking his trees and breaking his garden, and some of them are dismantling his house because they were angry because he was, even though they were ecstatically in love, he was manifested in very special ways. And some were chanting slogans about the Kazi. The Kazi was hiding upstairs. Nimai said to one of the servants of Kazi, please tell him that I have come in a very peaceful and friendly mood to speak to him. Chandrakasi came down to the doorstep, he was trembling. And Lord Chaitanya said, why, I am a guest who has come to your house. Why do you not welcome me? Why are you hiding somewhere? Chandrakasi said, well, this is not a very friendly group of people. Chandrakasi wanted to pacify everyone. He said, actually, Nilambar Chakravarti Thakur, your maternal grandfather, was very good friends with my father. So therefore, in our village customs, when we're close friends like this, we are family. I am your uncle. Even if an uncle makes a mistake, we're family, you should forgive me. And then they got in a very, very deep philosophical discussion about scripture, especially based on the killing of cows. Then Lord Chaitanya convinced him, not only according to Vedas. Lord Chaitanya said, why are you eating and killing cows? The Kazi said, well, even in your scripture, there is the Gomeda sacrifice. Lord Chaitanya said, that was for previous ages. Those kinds of sacrifices by the perfect pronunciation of mantra and the precision of the tantras and the yantras, an old cow gets a new life. But nobody could do that anymore. And then he proved how even on the basis of the Quran, the highest level is to be compassionate to the cow. And the Chandrakasi agreed. In fact, the Chandrakasi agreed with everything Lord Chaitanya said after some degree of debate. And then Lord Chaitanya said, why did you not try to stop this kirtan? Kazi said, it's a secret. I will tell you alone. And Lord Chaitanya said, these are all my confidential associates. You can say in front of all of them. He said, after I stopped one of the kirtan, I personally broke one of the mardangas. That night, I was sleeping in my palace, and I had a dream.
this incredible, awesome, fierce personality jumped on my chest. He had the face and the claws of a lion.
Viva!
And the body of a man. His eyes were ferociously red with anger, and his teeth were very sharp. And he said, because you broke my mridanga, because you disturbed my devotees, I will rip you apart today. And he roared. They were so razor sharp, and he dug them into my chest and started ripping me apart. And then he stopped. And he said, you have not done so much offenses yet. If you ever try to stop my sankirtan or hurt my devotees again, I will be back. Shri Nrsimha Dev Bhagavan Ki. Shankazi accepted Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The one God of all religions. It didn't say that he necessarily converted from one religion to another, because after all he was the Chankazi. But he accepted bhakti and the Supreme Lord as his life and soul, as his worshipful God. And he made a law. As long as any of my descendants are ruling over Nadia, they will never interfere. Rather, they will give all encouragement to the congregational chanting of the Holy Name. Chaitanya embraced the Chankasi. And even today, Gaudiya Vaishnavas go to honor him at his tomb, just close by, near Srimad. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then took the kirtan party, it's now early the next morning, and went to Srimad. By this time, not all the people, but some of the people were still there, especially Lord Chaitanya's close associates. They came by the little straw hut called the H.H.Radhanathi. Shridhar was so poor, materially. When Lord Chaitanya was, before he manifested his non-sankirtan movement, when he was just a little boy, he would go to cultivate Shridhar to argue the price of bananas. 2 hours every day. And usually would just take him for free. Cultivate Shridhar, Nimai said, he said, your clothes are so old. You have so many holes, and you just tie knots wherever there's holes. In your house, it's a leaky roof, it's one tiny room, it's made of clay and straw, and you have no furniture, you have no food, and your body's so skinny. But you are hiding your wealth. Someday I will reveal it to the world. Well, the richest we are was a pure unalloyed devotee. Day and night he would chant the holy names. He had one possession, a very old, rusted, dented iron pot that he would use for all purposes, to carry water, to clean himself. And that little pot was always just outside of his door.
It is said even the most desperate thief would not even cast a glance at that bottle. And he would drink from that bottle. And he would wash himself with that bottle. Lord Chaitanya saw the pot. In the presence of all these great, great devotees, during his kingdom, he had just conquered the Chankasi and all of his soldiers. And he was about to be conquered. When he saw that pot, he ran over and drank the water from it. Well, the major Sridhar saw this because he had already used this pot in that water. And he fell to the ground and said, "Now I am finished." And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, please see it in perspective of what just happened. He said, "Today, for the first time in my life, I am tasting the sweetness of pure love for Krishna because I have drunk the water from Kaldavaja Sridhar's pot." When he said that, he began to cry. His voice was all choked up in ecstasy. And all the devotees seeing the power of Kaldavaja Sridhar's love and seeing how Lord Chaitanya was conquered by that love, they all fell to the ground weeping and crying. And Vrindavan Das Thakur tells, "It is not by our knowledge or our wealth or our powers, but only by the sweetness and the humility of our devotion we actually attract the heart of the Lord. That we could use so much power and influence and wealth and all of these things, but it has to be built on the foundation of the simplicity of this love, as was exemplified by Lord Krishna." And as they saw Lord Chaitanya reveal this most priceless message to the whole world here in Mayapur Dham, the devotees celebrated. They raised their arms. They danced blissfully and chanted the Mahamantra.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
There were a few little drops from the unlimited, little parts of that single drop in the limited ocean of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes in another week, where he established the congregational chanting of the holy names. And now, this new temple that's being built, it was part of Srila Prabhupada's vision to bring people from all over the world to come here to Sri Mayapur to be purified by the power of the supreme spiritual blessings that are here in Mayapur, to associate with wonderful devotees, and to naturally be induced to chant the holy names. This kirtan may all of you have all come from is something very beautiful. It is very much the evolution of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Thank you very much.
Radhanathi Swami Maharaj, Jai!